from Channel 4 San Diego, this is One-on-One with Jane Mitchell.
Luis Castillo.
Defense!
The Chargers' future with a challenging past.
They could have easily made me an outcast, but they didn't. You know, they gave me the benefit of the doubt.
Determined to make his team and his mother proud.
It's something you just don't hear about in professional sports. Someone who used a substance banned in the NFL then takes the initiative to admit it, knowing he's put his career at risk. But that's what Luis Castillo did as a college senior. It's just part of his story, one that transcends the gridiron and goes to the heart of the old expression, honesty is the best policy.
Number 93, Luis Castillo.
I'm not one of the strongest players in terms of 300-pound defensive linemen, but I'm one of the quickest. And in terms of being mentally prepared, in terms of understanding what an offense is going to do, in terms of understanding how to play certain techniques when somebody's trying to do something to me,
Luis Castillo.
That's where I gained my edge.
The defensive end's agility and moves influenced by high school track and wrestling.
One-on-one learning to use your leverage against another man.
And perhaps by his Latin roots.
And Dominicans can dance now, so a little merengue and salsa and reggaeton.
While we're just getting to know the young Luis Castillo.
You know, nobody knows D lineman in this league, man.
In the Dominican Republic.
You're a real superstar.
It was like walking around in LT shoes out there.
Also impressive about this charming, clean-cut, cordial Northwestern University grad, his humility and honesty. He knows that being the Chargers' first-round draft pick in 2005, signing a five-year contract worth some $7 million, could have just as easily not have happened because of a mistake he says came with a one-time use of steroids in college.
It was more of, you know, I knew I was doing something wrong than knowing exactly what I was doing wrong. But I knew I was. I mean, I knew I was doing something I shouldn't have done.
The details of that personal drama later. But first, a look back.
One of the things that's made me the proudest in the last few months is having the opportunity to bring my mom here and seeing my mom, you know, laying by the pool, you know, sitting in the backyard, just enjoying the view and enjoying the fact that she knows that it's her son's house, her son who graduated from a great university with an economics degree, who's now a professional at 23 years old and has his own house. It's, you know, when I see that pride in her eyes, man, that makes it all worth it. And it's just such a special feeling.
His mother, Maria Castillo, understands English, but feels she can express herself better with an interpreter.
Éramos pobres. Mis padres eran personas campesinos, pobres.
We were very poor. My parents worked in the fields, and we had to work very hard in our family.
She is from the Dominican Republic, a family of eight, raised in a house with no running water, no electricity. Seeking more, she started a business and would travel to New York City to buy clothes to stock her Dominican boutique. On one such trip, she had a love affair, became pregnant, and chose to be a single mother at 39 years old.
Mi mamá decía siempre.
My mom really wanted me to have kids because she would always tell me that I worked very hard and then I needed to have kids. And Luis came into my life and he was a great surprise and the best thing that happened to me.
Luis was born August 4th, 1983, in New York, where they lived briefly with a relative in the projects. Then they returned to the Dominican so her family could help care for him. But she wanted more for Luis than her country could offer.
But I wanted him to be in the United States. I wanted him to grow up to be someone very important.
So it was back to New York with Luis to pursue the American dream by building her Dominican hair products import business. They lived simply on the top floor of a five-story building in the low-income area of Washington Heights.
My only memories are spending time with the babysitter while my mom was working, going to school and going straight back to the apartment and being there locked up without being able to have a backyard, without being able to go out and kind of hang around town with my friends just because it was a dangerous place to grow up and a dangerous place to be walking around the streets as a young kid with all these bad influences.
But even the walls of an apartment couldn't contain little Luis's energy.
Siempre estaba
He would always be playing with his cars, crashing them into something, crashing them to the wall. He just couldn't sit still.
He was a real boy.
Entonces era hombrecito.
Y le decía siempre muchas cosas buenas.
Every night, no matter how much I worked, I would come home and sit in bed with him and always tell him a lot of great things, that he was born to do something great, that he had a big future ahead of him.
His aunts and uncles gave him the same encouragement.
And when you're a little kid and you hear this over and over and over again, it puts a sense of responsibility of you, but it also, I mean, there's just no way you could let that down.
He had a special charisma, and because of that, I was instilled in that. He would look in the mirror and make sure that he knew that he had to be that person.
To help him get there, a move when he was 8, a half hour away to a working class community, Garfield, New Jersey.
When I got the chance to live in a place where I had a backyard, I had a basement I could play in, I could go out on the street and ride my bike and play catch in the backyard. I mean, it was just a whole different world.
He struggled in school until the 6th grade when he became fluent in English. Signing up to play football at 11 came with an unexpected benefit for a kid growing up without a father.
My mom did everything she needed to do to give me a great life, but she wasn't that male figure in the house. And I think it made a big impact in me when I got the chance to play a sport where I had all these male figures that now, you know, changed my personality a bit and helped mold me into the person I am today.
Namely, Garfield High School football coach, Steve Mucha.
Let's go,
from just, you know, going out there every day and just playing a sport just cuz, to really devoting myself to it and dedicating myself to taking that next step and to putting in the work that it took to gain that college scholarship. And he showed me that was a possibility, that was something I could achieve.
Starting with talent and skill, a big kid at 6'1", 200 pounds, Coach Mucha brought him in to play varsity the last game of his freshman year.
It was like the third quarter, and I'd been hiding all game trying to stay away from coach so he wouldn't put me in because I was a scared little freshman.
And Luis hits a swim move, pass rush move. He sacks the quarterback. And it was like, wow.
Luis was well-rounded, popular, a leader as a math and Spanish honor society student, involved in school activities, as well as track, wrestling, and football. Developing confidence on the gridiron and making local headlines by his junior year.
Regardless of your physical abilities, regardless of the talents you have, when you have that confidence, I mean, it opens up a world of possibilities.
He proved himself 2 years in a row in the state playoffs against Ramapo. Luis Castillo was voted an all-state player, and colleges showed interest.
It was just such an amazing experience to feel that, you know, you'd taken that step and accomplished something, knowing that you were gonna save your mom all that money and she wasn't gonna have to pay for you to go to school. And to know that, you know, you were making your family proud.
Up next, a decision that tests Luis Castillo's character. And later on One-on-One, grit, gratitude, and giving back. When Luis Castillo had interest from more than 30 colleges, he accepted a full scholarship from Northwestern University in Chicago. He chose it for its academics and football program. The Wildcats were Big Ten co-champions in 2000, and he wanted to play under head coach Randy Walker.
He pushed us, and he pushed us hard, because he knew what we could accomplish if we really, you know, dedicated ourselves and put our entire mind, body, and heart into achieving what he wanted for us.
And what Luis Castillo wanted for himself.
And I remember being in college listening to the media talk about, you know, the defensive tackles at USC or Texas or Florida or Ohio State and Michigan. And I'm sitting there thinking, wow, those guys are so good. I'd love to be like those guys.
As a junior, he realized he was like those guys, those NFL prospects, because of his success against them on the field. Coach Eric Washington remembers.
The first game, watching him chase the ball, watching him compete, watching him neutralize his opponent, I think that when it was really clear to me that he had a chance to really play at the next level.
It all came down to his life-changing senior year.
Because you know that NFL teams have you on their radar, you know they're giving you the possibility of becoming a first-day draft pick, and all of a sudden, the second play of my first game, I tore my ulnar collateral ligament in my elbow. They kind of taped it up and wrapped it up and was able to finish the game kind of just with my arm at my side.
He had two choices,
play, hoping he'd do well enough to be drafted, or have surgery and return for a fifth year. Prepared to have surgery, he recalls a conversation with his coaches about the team and his future.
We feel like we could do some pretty amazing things, and we need you, and we have nobody else. So, you know, we feel like you could be a good enough player for us, one arm and all, and without being able to practice. And I made the decision to stay. I couldn't let him down.
Contributing, but not to his standards. Postseason surgery would mean 6 months of rehab. With the clock ticking, just 2 months away from the combine, where NFL teams assess what young players can do, he decides
to not have the surgery and try to just push through it.
The pain subsided, but he was behind in his strength and weight training. So, he says, not to gain a competitive advantage, but just to cope and catch up, he accepted a tempting offer.
Who offered you what, and did you know what they were offering you?
It was somebody that was around the program and had been around for a few years and had seen us play. And, you know, when he saw me in that situation, it came up. But it was honestly something where I just couldn't allow myself to go into the combine and to go in and let myself be presented to 32 NFL teams and to hundreds of scouts in all this training and not be the type of player I was, not be prepared like I wanted to be. And
did you know you were taking steroids when he gave them to you?
It was something where honestly it was more of, you know, I knew I was doing something wrong than knowing exactly what I was doing wrong. But I knew I was. I mean, I knew I was doing something I shouldn't have done, and I made the decision that, you know, I've worked so hard to get to here. I got to do whatever it takes. I got to do whatever it takes to make sure I'm where I need to be, and I made the decision I did.
Did you tell anybody else about it?
No.
Turns out he took Androstenedione Dion, or Andro, a supplement the body converts to testosterone, said to improve strength and muscle development. It's banned in the NFL.
How did that affect your ability to perform?
There was so much involved in that whole process of recovering. I mean, I put so much time. I mean, I was doing rehab on my elbow 5 days a week. And then you look at all the training. I mean, we were training 6 days a week, lifting twice a day, and doing all we needed to do to be able to get back. So honestly, I mean, I don't know if it made that big of an impact or not.
So how did you perform at the combine?
Perform well.
But that decision to take Andro, even as a college student, would come back to haunt him 2 weeks before the 2005 NFL draft.
And it's the ugliest situation I've ever been in my life, and it was so tough to deal with because for the first time in my life, I'd really let people down.
Flying back from meeting with the New England Patriots, he landed in Chicago. He returned a call from his mother, who was worried because a letter had arrived from the NFL saying he had tested positive for steroid use.
And I just went to my car and cried and just, you know, couldn't believe the fact that I'd worked so hard to put myself in a position to take that next step and become an NFL player. And all of a sudden, to me, it was all gone. I mean, it wasn't a possibility anymore. I thought, you know, as soon as I heard, I thought it was all gone. I thought there was no way that somebody was going to give me the chance to prove myself.
He called his agent, Mike McCartney.
Kind of what I talked to him was, you know, I've already made this mistake, and I don't want to go out there and lie and try to, you know, make excuses for it, because in the end nobody really believes the excuses anyways. And a lot of agents would have pushed me to say a lie and to try to make up some kind of excuse, to make up some kind of, you know, I didn't know what it was, or I didn't know what was going on. It was something in my orange juice or something. And I'm real thankful that he encouraged me and helped me make the decision I did.
The decision to write a letter to every team in the National Football League.
I mean, I just remember sitting down and trying to type this letter in which you admit to, you know, the biggest mistake you've ever made in your life.
The letter was part of a package showing his track record and that the 3.5 academic All-American had never failed a drug test in college. It was sent to all 32 NFL teams, including the San Diego Chargers. Head coach Marty Schottenheimer.
He recognized that an error was made, and he fully accepted responsibility for that. And assured us it would never happen again, assured everybody it would never happen again. And when you put all the pieces together and you do your due diligence, it became very, very apparent to the San Diego Chargers that this is a young man that would fit in nicely here, not only as a player, but importantly as a person.
So take us to draft day.
Wow. You know, when you talk about the NFL draft, it's the biggest unknown there is. When you talk about the NFL draft and the situation I was in, I had no idea. I mean, I had no idea if I was going to be a first-round pick or if I was going to be a free agent.
He'd finally know with a call from Schottenheimer.
The San Diego Chargers select Luis Castillo.
San Diego had two picks in the first round. The Chargers took Sean Merriman and Luis Castillo.
Thank you for the opportunity. Thank you for believing in me. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to go out there and prove myself. Thank you, because that's all I ever wanted was the opportunity. Thank you. And that's how the entire conversation went.
Meanwhile, some players commentating on ESPN's television coverage of the draft.
Now there is a story here.
Criticized Castillo.
They're saying, hey, you know, here's the guy who cheated the system.
I wasn't going to get mad at somebody for voicing an opinion or for stating what they felt. Because I realized, you know, I had no right to try to get in anybody's face or to try to be mad at somebody for stating something that was pretty real.
Humbled but relieved, Luis Castillo joined the Chargers at training camp.
I'm so thankful to my teammates because they really treated it the right way, and they could have easily, you know, gone against me. They could have easily made me an outcast, but they didn't. You know, they gave me the benefit of the doubt.
To come out and be upfront about that, like, I mean, that says a lot about his character, you know, that shows that he's a man, you know, and, you know, it's hard to find that in some guys.
I mean, that's one chapter of your life. You put it behind you, you move on to your next chapter.
We're going to give you the chance to come out here and be one of our teammates and help this team win.
Luis Castillo is chalking up a lot of firsts. His first sack of 2006 against rival Oakland.
You talk about the Raiders, you talk about the first week of the season, you talk about Monday Night Football. It just couldn't have been any better.
And down he goes again at the 45-yard line.
His first interception ever.
Look how athletic the big defensive end out of Northwestern can be.
And the first of Dominican heritage to be drafted by and start in the NFL. He represents a Caribbean nation where baseball dominates. So while he often visited his mother's homeland, returning as a Charger seems the whole country celebrates his success.
From government officials to people on the street to see the love and the, you know, the support they'd give me in a sport which they really don't understand, in a game where they really never watched before. It was just such a fun experience and such a great experience and such an honor to be out there knowing that I represent that country in this game.
Not a bit shy, singing in Spanish. His natural stage presence parallels his confidence and moves on the football field, even with the pressure as a rookie in 2005.
You come in as a first-round pick, and there's so many expectations, especially for me, you know, with everything that had happened.
A sprained foot early on didn't help, but then, with other player injuries, Castillo became a starter fast.
The first 6-7 games, even though I was the starter, I wasn't playing anywhere near the level that I should have been at, because there was just so much I still needed to learn.
By midseason,
it was Kansas City Chiefs, the 8th game of the year. I had my first sack. I think I had a sack and a half that game, and everything started taking off from there.
The defensive lineman is appreciated by his team for both his talent and personality.
He's funny. He hugs everybody's mom. He kisses everybody's mom. He calls everybody's mom.
Luis Castillo is one of those guys that's always had a smile on his face. He's just so energetic and always just, you know, ready to play.
In only his second year, but he's really playing great for us, and certainly a big key to our defensive success in stopping the run.
The sky's the limit for him because, A, he has the physical skills that are necessary. B, he understands football and knows how to go about the preparation part, which is so critical. And as I said before, he's got a great, great competitiveness about him. And when you put those pieces together, you come up with a pretty, pretty solid player.
As for ever considering using steroids or the like again?
For the rest of my career, I never have to worry about that. You know, I made a promise to this team. I made a promise to my family. And not only in terms of my character, but in terms of money too. You know, it's I promise to give it all back if I ever made that kind of mistake.
Lesson learned, lesson shared. He embraces being a role model at his former schools and part of the Chargers' efforts in the community with autograph signings, talking with kids.
We just wanted to say thank you to you all for coming today.
And going south of the border to Mexico.
I mean, show them what an NFL player is like. You know, you don't have to be a stuck-up, you know, cocky guy. You can be a humble person and do the things you do and have fun with it.
Luis Castillo works hard.
I'll do 20 of those.
Works out. A natural athlete who is all about preparation.
I devote my week to getting in the best shape possible to know that I'm going to be fresh when somebody else is tired in the fourth quarter.
In football lingo, it's called having a motor. When Castillo isn't working, he's usually at home.
Growing up in a big old project building in New York to all of a sudden having this great backyard and this great view where I could just hang out and relax. I'm a firm believer, if you work hard, you rest hard, and that's what I do. I enjoy just laying around doing nothing.
On game weekends, his mother, who lives out east, is here too.
Su abuelo pie.
Inside, his bachelor pad's in the decorating phase, with a pool table serving as a temporary display for photos, awards, and media coverage in English and Spanish. A sentimental guy collecting his experiences, such as guest hosting an American Latino TV show.
All right, enough about me. Now we're going to check out some of the...
A long way from his mother's starting point.
It all goes back to my mom. It all goes back to seeing the things she was able to do in her life because of her dedication, because of her hard work, to know that she had that sense of responsibility, that when somebody was trusting on her to accomplish something, she couldn't let them down. That's kind of the way I am, and that's the reason why I was able to be successful in school and in football, because, you know, it was the same way, whether it be on the football field or taking a test, you know, I couldn't go into something unprepared.
Maria says Luis and her company, now a multi-million dollar business, grew up together.
I'd always heard people talking about the American dream, and I know that I've done it, and really thank God and my son. I want to take this opportunity to thank the San Diego Chargers for believing in my son, and I'm a big San Diego Charger fan. Look at my nails, I dress up in the colors, I'm always there. It's just something really great.
I would love to sit with my mom in a football game that I'm playing in. For a little woman from the Dominican Republic who'd never seen football before, to seeing the love and the understanding she has for the game now, it's truly amazing.
Yeah.
Do you want to meet your dad?
I do. And I actually, you know, I was lucky enough through the NFL, I was able to find him.
Planning a trip to Europe to meet him with his mother.
She just said, you know, he was younger and he really wasn't ready and he made a bad decision. And people make mistakes and sometimes you got to forgive them. So I'd love the opportunity to go out there and get a chance to meet him.
Forgiveness and understanding, subjects he knows something about.
I'm thankful to the organization for giving me this opportunity and giving me this chance. And I feel like I owe him a lot. And every day my goal is to go out there and do everything I can to make them look good.
So your mom was right. You were destined for something great.
I guess the family had it pegged right, man. And it's, you know, I'm just thankful I was able to live up to all their expectations because they definitely had high, high expectations.
Luis Castillo's plan going into college was to graduate, then take over his mother's business so she could retire. As he puts it, football got in the way. Not a bad detour for someone who, although not perfect, seems determined to make the most out of his NFL opportunity of a lifetime. I'm Jane Mitchell. Thank you for watching One on One.
Stay with Channel 4 San Diego for more exciting, unique local programming. Channel 4 San Diego, only on cable television, not available on satellites.